What's going on, everyone? It's Brian with Chicoji Fine Jewelry, your personal jeweler. Recently, I swiped up to get iced up. If you guys know what that means, it's from Supreme Patty, his Instagram. If you don't know who Supreme Patty is, he does a lot of like stunts and tricks, just a lot of goofy, wild things that are entertaining for Instagram. I think he has a YouTube as well, but people been reaching out to me because he offers the, if it's free if you pay for shipping and handling service for jewelry. Obviously it's fake pieces, but people ask about my opinion on it, so I just swiped up. It took about a month to deliver, but they were from China, so that's probably the reason why. So I'm gonna do an in-depth review. Before I do this, I need to put this disclaimer out there because a lot of people watch like 2 minutes of this video and jump on me for my review like they did with the gold shop or shop gold. It's my personal belief in a business is no matter if you're buying the $5 product or the more expensive product, the quality integrity of each product should be the same. One is lesser because maybe it's smaller, whatever, but it should not be bad quality. Let me break it down furthermore for some of you because I think I need to do that. You probably didn't understand. If you're going in to, if you're going to McDonald's and you're at, gonna order from the dollar menu, that dollar menu shouldn't give you food poisoning. It should still taste as good as a Big Mac or about the same. It's just a little smaller of a portion, but it should be the same integrity that McDonald's has. Not that McDonald's has a lot of integrity, but it's still pretty bomb, you guys gotta admit. So that is my take. So when watching that, keep that in mind. I mean, it should be that, like, my 1 millimeter rope chain has the same integrity, the same quality finish and purity as a 10 millimeter rope chain. So that's just how it's done. That's how I base these reviews. I don't give any less or keep in mind that it only cost me $5. So I've talked too much. I just want to say this so that way all you guys don't jump on me for that opinion. It's just my opinion. So with that being said, let's get started. All right, here we go. Now I put a side by side of each real pieces. I'm not trying to plug here for people that say, oh, I just try to make these look bad. Don't even go on my website. Don't even shop Chicoji. I don't care. I just want to show those who are curious the difference so you know and learn. That's what it's all about. Now the rope chain, stainless steel, which isn't bad as far as jewelry, but when you try to plate it, then that's the problem. And my most popular video is spotting fake gold, is this discoloration right there. Honestly, guys, like the other websites that sell a little more expensive rope chains definitely do look better than this. This is really bad. I mean, the only good thing about this piece, maybe that lobster clasp, it's pretty nice and sturdy, but other than that, I just wouldn't recommend, even though I think shipping, I don't know what, with $10 or whatever it was, I just wouldn't recommend anyone buying or wearing this rope chain. It's featherweight and it's very bad quality. I don't like it at all. You compare it to a real one, and most, no matter if you go to K Jewelers, whatever jewelry store you go to, most of these ropes are gonna kind of look the same, or they should. This one, 14 karat gold, this is a 4 millimeter. You get a nice, more natural look compared to this. This is just really garbage. I mean, I don't know, I'm very disappointed in this, but again, it was free. Even though I said I'm not gonna put disclaimers out there, but Supreme Patty's cool, so. But anyways, it's just a bad rope chain. It's too light, it's very bad. Just look at that color. Like, I don't even know why you'd even wanna put that around your neck. Like, who are you fooling? People that know jewelry, know gold, know exactly how much you paid for that. So, well, you only paid shipping, right? Now, this is the Miami Cuban link. I only got a 7-inch, that's all they had in stock, so it doesn't even fit me. I'm a 7.5-inch. But I mean, for this, the spacing is terrible, like the links, but I'm not gonna get too choosy. I do like the box clasp on this. It fits and it works really well. Like, some cheap ones won't work that well, but this one, the clasp, the box clasp itself is made very nicely. I was surprised and kind of impressed. Oh, out of the two pieces, definitely this Cuban link wins, even though this is like a nightmare. I hate, and I understand why they do it. Like, a lot of cheap jewelers will, they're selling cheap jewelry, will rhodium plate the diamonds because they're just really small. Most of the time they're very bad quality. In this case, they're not diamonds at all, but I just don't like the look. I'd rather just have more of the yellow look than like the white, but you can even see it's like hollow in the back. But this one, I wish I could put it on the wrist. It doesn't work. And then here's my 8 millimeter diamond Miami Cuban link. I don't rhodium my diamonds. I just let them, but there's so many diamonds and they're tightly set that it's all white right there. But this is very small, and that's the thing. You're gonna spend a bunch of money on a real diamond bracelet set in 14 karat gold, or I think I spent like $45 on this thing. But again, people that see this, if you're wearing this in public, and people that know jewelry are gonna know what this is about. Same thing with this. I have a lot of people that, and same thing with hollow jewelry too. It breaks and everything. There's no real getting around investing in some nicer pieces. People say, well, diamonds are a waste of money. They're marked up, and gold is this, gold is that. You pay too much. That's all debatable, and that's a different topic for another day. But these right here are just bad. I like this one a lot more than this one. I know some of you might be saying, Brian, I can't afford gold and diamonds. I don't want to invest in gold and jewelry. It's too marked up. Anyways, that's all fine. You got to do what you got to do. But I just wouldn't recommend that to you. It's very bad quality. I've seen all the fake, like the shop gold, the gold shop. Those are better qualities. They have the returns. You could send it in if it breaks the warranty. All those stuff. At least you might spend a little bit more and have that peace in mind, and overall a better quality of fake pieces. That way you could enjoy it a little bit more. I don't know, I don't recommend fake jewelry to anybody, but I know a lot of people want it to wear it, but to me it all looks cheap. That's all a different point though. I just want to make this review. The thing is also, you see Supreme Patty on Instagram, he's got the real deal on. He's got diamond chokers and custom pieces. So a lot of these kids that see it maybe think, oh, that's what I'm gonna get, that's the quality I'm gonna get. And that's the problem. It's nothing compared, it's not close to it. It's like he has the real deal on, just like I have the real deal on. But yet you get a package in the mail, you see, like, you follow all these Instagram jewelers, Aviani, Ben Ball, you see all these really nice pieces, and that's kind of the expectation these days, and then you get something that looks like that and it just doesn't look good at all. So again, when it comes to fake jewelry, you gotta shop around. Overall, I would not recommend those pieces, but made the video, made the review. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it. If you want me to review any other company, leave a comment down below. That's it for today's video. And we'll see you on our next jewelry video.